bomb making expert Mohammad Ghani Usman is presently in a prison in Paris, arrested in the aftermath of the 2015 terror attacks in the French capital. Usman also happens to be a Lashkar-e-Toiba operative wanted by India as a key plotter of the 2611 terror attacks in Mumbai. A new documentary aired by the German state broadcaster has tracked down the meticulous planning, financing and commissioning of terror attacks in Europe. Indian investigating agencies probing the Mumbai terror attack, in which 166 people lost their lives, have linked Usman to the Pakistani terror groups Lashkar-e-Toiba and Lashkar-e-Jhangvi. The NIA even questioned Usman in 2019. According to the NIA, Usman was in touch with David Coleman Headley, the Pakistani terrorist of US origin, who plotted the 2008 terror strike. Interestingly, Usman, who in 2008 was linked with the Lashkar-e-Toiba, managed to sneak into Europe along with an Algerian ISIS fighter, Adel Haddadi, as a part of the ISIS strike group. According to the documentary, the two managed to sneak into Europe along with the Syrian migrant wave. The two used fake Syrian passports, which is what led to their arrest in Austria. And subsequently, they were extradited to France. One of the Paris attackers of 2015 was in regular correspondence with them days before the attack and had even boasted that as many as 90 ISIS fighters had managed to infiltrate into Europe. Another shadowy figure the documentary highlights is that of Sajid Mir. This is the only known photograph of him. Mir presently lives in Pakistan and carries a bounty of $5 million. He is charged with actively recruiting and indoctrinating Westerners with the aim of sending them back to Europe and the United States to carry out terror attacks. The German documentary has once again exposed the deep links of the Pakistani terror groups and the active support that they get from the ISI and the Pakistani deep state. Our principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhant Sibyl, getting us more on this. Siddhant, this is a development that certainly once again raises question marks over Pakistan's stance on terror.
Well, a pretty interesting documentary that shows the links between the Paris attacks, the 2611 attacks, but reaffirms that how Pakistan remains the epicenter of global terrorism. But somewhere West has been missing out on that. While it has been calling Pakistan as its ally, Pakistan has also been its adversary in terms of aiding, supporting terrorism. And the documentary, the 30-minute long documentary, in a sense shows that how the Mumbai terror attacks were in a sense first of the series of terror attacks which we saw almost entire this decade in Europe, and how in a sense Lashkar-e-Toiba, a group of course well known here in the Indian subcontinent, was in a sense much more dangerous than Al-Qaeda, and how in a sense Lashkar-e-Toiba was responsible and has linkages with many terror attacks which happened in Europe. But nonetheless, the documentary comes in a week when we know that the FATF is meeting, and the announcement is expected towards the end of this week. And it is expected, of course, Pakistan remains on the grey list. Pakistan still needs to act on various ways through which financing of terrorism can be controlled. But it looks like that the entire support to terrorism has had a major impact on the Pakistani society. There has been considerable radicalization. And that was one of the reasons that earlier this week we saw how the Pakistani foreign minister hesitated to term Osama bin Laden as a terrorist. This is primarily because it looks that he was pandering to his domestic audience as well, an audience that supports aiding and abetting of terrorism, not only in the region, but across the world now. And this documentary, in a sense, is a proof of Pakistan's continued support to terrorism. That is something that India and, of course, Afghanistan have been raising at many multilateral forums for many, many years. But it looks like, again, the West is believing in Pakistan, that Pakistan will be, in a sense, ally when it comes to war against terrorism. But in a sense that Pakistan is the main culprit.
Siddhant, we're going to leave it there for the moment.